What is going on, everybody? James Hancock here. I'm back to do a reaction video to the first official full-length trailer for F9, the Fast Saga, aka the ninth movie in the Fast and Furious franchise. I guess 10th if you include Hobbs and Shaw, and obviously that's part of the giant saga, but it feels like because of the rift between The Rock and Vin Diesel, perhaps we'll be seeing Hobbs and Shaw movies off to the side, but I hope they'll collide at some point because obviously John Cena and The Rock, they need a fight in one of these movies, but this movie is coming out on May 22nd. Tickets are already on sale. They've been doing this giant concert today to promote the release of this trailer. Cardi B performed, Ludacris, a bunch of other people. But the big thing for me with this movie is this is the return of director Justin Lin. I think, while I wouldn't necessarily say I'm the most rabid fan for the franchise, I'm fascinated by the creative pivot that took place between the third movie, Tokyo Drift, and the sixth, which was just called Fast and Furious 6. Justin Lin directed 3, 4, 5, and 6. And that's where we saw this franchise become one of the biggest franchises of the 21st century. I mean, if you think about it, these movies have been around for almost 20 years at this point, but it's only been since Justin Lin's influence that it really became this giant mega franchise, like up there with Marvel. And I know for a lot of people out there, like my co-founder of my podcast, Wrong Reel, he likes the Fast and Furious franchise more than Marvel movies. So I'm always curious about it. I see every movie. The only one that I've seen multiple times is Fast 5. But I definitely enjoy these. I just wouldn't say I'm like a fanatic. But I'll be curious to see what Justin Lin wants to do with the franchise moving forward, because it's rumored he's going to be coming back for number 10 as well. What's got me most excited is that Francis Ngannou is going to be in this. And if you don't know who that is, he is a heavyweight fighter in the UFC. He's fought for the belt, but he hasn't become champ yet. He probably will be champ at some point, but he is absolutely terrifying. Seeing what he did to Alistair Overeem, I thought Alistair Overeem was dead. I mean, like the back of his head basically touched the back of his neck. But he's not the only new addition. We got Michael Rooker joining the franchise, which is really cool. There's a lot of stuff to look forward to in this. But I think maybe perhaps I've rambled enough at this point. Maybe I should go ahead and watch this sucker. I'm just going to check to make sure I'm still recording. I'm just going to press pause real quick and come right back. All right, still recording. I just had to check because sometimes, for whatever reason, my computer loves to freeze when I'm doing trailer reaction videos. But let's go ahead and start this trailer right now. Start the timer before they mention family.
I used to live my life a quarter mile at a time. But things changed. I'm a father now.
He said father.
I will always be in your heart.
You hadn't said family yet.
Little Brian.
You can feel it coming.
Your daddy gave me this. Now I'm gonna give it to you. It's very special. It's for protection from what's coming.
I'm going to make a prediction right now. 20 years from now, they'll still be making these movies, and you'll see all their kids. It's the new generation.
All right, Dom. What's next?
No matter how fast you are,
I am not to be compared to you.
No one outruns their past.
I am more easy, you trying your best to become me.
And mine. Whoa. Just caught up to me.
John Cena's just—he's too big. It's just bizarre.
So we're up against a master thief, assassin, high-performance driver. Who is he?
Jacob is Dom's brother.
Oh, shit.
Your whole life, you pushed yourself to be faster than Dom. Smarter than Dom. Stronger than Dom. But could you kill him? Because I'm ready if you are.
I kind of like Charlize Theron's hair doing the last
There's
one much better.
There's nothing more powerful than the love of family. But you turn that into anger. There's nothing more dangerous.
I adore her.
Maybe this is the end, but we won't go out together.
You know I'd ride to the death with you.
Not the end. These movies make $1 billion a pop.
Let's get to work.
Please tell me that's not a Pontiac Fiero strapped to a rocket engine?
Impressive. I know.
No. No, that's not impressive.
Fuego! your mistake. This is my world.
But more over the top these get, the more I enjoy them. Like, go all in. Bring in aliens if you want. I don't care.
They got a magnet plane?
Hold on.
Tell me you're not thinking what I think you're thinking. There's no bridge!
Oh, hell no.
All right.
Hey, guys. Surprise.
Nice clubhouse.
Whoa. So, back from the dead. Now, if memory serves correctly, the continuity or the order of events, I know that while the movies came out in a certain order, I think number three is supposed to take place after number six, and then it resumes to number seven. I haven't watched three and six in quite a while, but he was a great part of the cast, so bring him on back. Wow. Like I said, I like these movies. The more ridiculous they get, the more over the top, the more they feel like G.I. Joe and steroids, the more enjoyable I think they are. I actually wasn't that interested in the franchise when it's a bunch of kind of like drag racing and that sort of thing. But real quick, I just got to check. All right, so I was blanking on the name of the actor who plays Han, but it is Sung Kang. I always thought he was a really cool part of the team, so I'm more than happy to see him come back. I imagine for the fanatics of the franchise, they're going to collectively pee their pants when they see him back on the screen. But obviously, super cool actor, so yeah, bring him on. What else? I guess the big question for me is, at what point does this franchise just go full superhero? Obviously, with Idris Elba and Hobbs and Shaw, he kept calling himself Black Superman, and the way he dressed was almost more appropriate for like a Marvel movie than for a Fast and Furious movie, but people like superheroes. And the stuff that they do in this now is actually more over the top than what a lot of superheroes do. Like, if you look at superhero movies with like Batman or Black Widow or anybody who doesn't really have powers, but just a lot of kind of cool gadgets and fighting skills, like, the stuff they do is pretty tame in comparison to what Dom and his family do in these movies. So, like I said, bring in the aliens, go to outer space, bring in superheroes, bring in whatever you like. Or if you want to do like a genre mashup where they end up having a collision with the Conjuring franchise or the Transformers franchise, I don't care. The weirder, the better. I just feel like when it comes to this franchise, there should just be absolutely no rules. And they, like I said, they can keep the thing going indefinitely. People love these characters so much, and these movies make so much money. I guarantee you, if Vin Diesel came out in a wheelchair 20 years from now just to say the word family in a cameo in a Fast and Furious movie starring his children and grandchildren, people would still cheer and go berserk and so on and so forth. So, yeah, I don't expect Universal to stop making these movies anytime soon, because this is Universal's only major franchise. It's just it's a license to print money. So May 22nd, I'll definitely be there. Excited to see it, but looking forward to hearing what people think. But thanks so much for watching this reaction video. If you enjoyed it, please consider subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate it. But hope everyone has a great weekend. But more importantly, as always, onwards and upwards.